August 19th, 2014. Please stand for the flag salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Let the record show that all council members are present. I call for a motion to approve the agenda as it is written.
I so move that we approve the agenda as written.
Can I get a second? Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion's carried. We have, for the council members, anybody that has not really worked in the city, some free classes for show you what goes into planning a city. So I would recommend that anybody that would like to know what goes into city planning to attend these classes, and they can come see me if they want to go to it. I'm going to go to it myself, and we get a good experience.
Where are the classes at?
They're going to be done with the Department of Commerce.
Where?
Let's see, Buckley, Pasco, Ocean Shore, Zilla, Spokane, and I'm sure they have more coming up. Tumwater. So I'm going to see what's going to win the local one is going to be. But it's a short course. And it's a general overview.
Can anybody that hasn't been to that class, they can take it off of the internet, can't they?
I'm not sure, but I can check on that.
I don't know if they get certificates on the internet or not, but they had that class from the Attorney General's office.
And it doesn't look like it has it on the internet. But I'll double check and see if they do have that option. Chief?
A few things nationally. That was a lot of fun. Deputy Greiner did a really good job. He did most of the work putting that together this year, and he had a little bit of experience doing the same kind of thing, not National Night Out, but planning similar types of events down in Arizona where he used to work. And so he did a great job and was able to come up with some ideas for things to do that I haven't come up with before. So that was a lot of fun. And then we've just been busy and running all over, whether it be closer to Monroe or further out here. You know, they caught a burglar this morning using a police dog, and the other one got away from him, but they're still working on that. And we're just moving right along. So on a personal note, my kids went to Roller Derby Nationals in Florida for the Junior Roller Derby Association National Championships and took second place in their division. They had two divisions, and they were the second division because they're a new team. But as a brand new team, newer than any other team there, they were still able to take second place. I think they probably broke a record skating 8 full roller derby bouts in about 2.5 days. And I've never seen people so tired.
Good deal.
John?
Yeah, we had a water service breakup on First Street. I ran, and when it gets underneath the asphalt, it's pretty hard to locate. You just can't start. Well, it's bubbling up here. You'll start tearing all kinds of asphalt out to find the leak. So I got a hold of Evergreen Rural Water, who we're a member of. And they came out. Richard and I, we didn't have anything to cut asphalt with. We didn't have anything to cut anything with because our old cutoff saw is basically worn out. And so we talked with the mayor, and she gave us permission to go buy a cutoff saw, because we needed one. It was about $1,150, somewhere in there. That way we have a cutoff saw, we used it to cut the asphalt, and we can use it in the middle of the night, you know, if we wanted to rent one, we would have had it, and taken it back. Then if the same thing happens in the middle of the night, then we're up the creek pretty bad. Anyway, Evergreen River Water, they located within a foot and a half of where the leak was. And we dug it out, and we fixed it. And we had two people without water for not very long. And so, if we look at our SCADA system, it's been leaking for a while, and we can tell by the graft, it's gonna help with our water use efficiency also, since we fixed that leak. And then on a personal note, it's not as fun as what you're doing, it's not. After tonight in the morning, I gotta head south, take care of some personal business, and then I'll be back right after the holidays. But it'll be a tough time, but it'll be a fun time too. So. Any questions from anybody? And congratulations. That's cool. Thank you.
No, nothing at this time.
Nothing.
I've got some response from Volunteers of America that they want to partner with us to help the community center. Today they are holding orientation for volunteers. She'll be getting a hold of me by email soon. So, it's a beginning.
What Chief Casey said about National Night Out. It was fun. Missed the helicopters, but you know what? That's okay. We'll see them next year. And I just have to tell you, I went down to the station to, you know, hop in the, I think I drove the 8 car. And Chief Andrews says, oh, by the way, Snowpack wants us to do a smart 911 table. You tell me now. He had just found out that day. So I had a whole box of stuff and a whole banner. So if anybody has heard of Smart 911, we're trying to get the word out. You have to go on your computer to smart911.com, I believe, and you sign into it and you put as much personal information into it as you want. Because one of the things that frustrates us and police is that people call on cell phones and need help. Well, a cell phone isn't tied into any address, so we have no idea, no clue where you are. And on this Smart 911, you can post pictures of dogs, of kids. So if you have an Amber Alert, they have the picture immediately. You can put down people with medical conditions, people who might have Alzheimer's, people who are crippled in some way and might need extra help getting extricated if there's a fire or something else. It's marvelous. All confidential. Police and fire are the only people that can see this information. And I just encourage everybody to consider doing that, because it just helps you. And like I said, you can put as much or as little as you want. But it's something that Snowpack is doing. It's free. Snowpack is paying for it. They got a grant. And so, were you aware of it?
Yes.
Yes. And it's, yeah. It's been in the newspaper. Yep.
What was that .com again?
Smart911.com. And you can put as much or as little information and all kinds of good stuff.
Smart.
Yeah, it's really a benefit.
They're sending out cards, business cards with the information on there, just to be able to log on to the site. When those get here, we'll post them out here on the calendar.
And the fire station has got handout flyers, and I think they have the little cards. I should have grabbed some. Anyway, they have handouts at the fire station, if anybody wants to know more.
Is that just in Snohomish County, or?
I think it is. It's just Snowpack. Right?
It's a big organization.
Yeah.
Snohomish County just joined.
Right now, it's just Snowpack sponsoring, but I'm sure it'll go more.
Yeah, I wonder about the cell phones and calling.
Well, you know, you get people that are in the back of nowhere, and they call you and they say, well, we just had an ATV accident, we're next to a big tree.
Right.
Okay, I'll be right there. All?
Nothing at this time.
Do you have any comments from Susan?
Yes, sir.
I just, Leroy Turner from State Route 2 here. Okay, I just was talking to John a minute ago, but just seeing where you're at on Gun Road, on the edges of the road. And it's almost all summer now, we still haven't got any done.
Prison work crews, they're having problems even filling the work crews. So we've decided to, never mind about that, we're trying to get an estimate and just get them on it. And I'm not sure if we can get a general estimate so fast or prior.
What we did is I met with the person who did it last time, but I thought he would be here tonight, give us an estimate of what was going to cost. But he's not here tonight, so we didn't get the estimate. As soon as we get it, I'll look for the council.
Is he going to fix it so that you can mow it?
Pardon?
Is he going to fix it so that you guys can mow it?
Well, what he's going to do is he's going to cut both sides, the brush back, then he's going to go as wide as it was, so it's two lane. He's going to pull his shoulders to the center of the road, then he's going to pick it up and dispose of it. Then I'll take the street sweeper and sweep it up, so that's the plan.
We're also getting an estimate to.
Starting to turn into one lane at the other end again.
Yeah.
I know, I've been down there several times trying to get this going.
Looks really nice across the street. It's an A-plus over there, but it's an F-minus down there.
Exactly. That's why I'm trying to push this. Not sure if we can get okay from the council without the press on it yet, because it's previously.
The council could move to give you a ceiling that they would not be willing to spend over, or give you a guideline if they wanted to.
Yeah, and I have no idea what he's going to charge.
I wish I'd wait till you got your estimate.
Pardon?
I wish I'd wait till you get the estimate.
Yeah.
Hopefully it doesn't take as long as it does last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it really needs to be done as well, when the next council is September 2nd.
Well, if we want to bring businesses into this town, we just got to keep care of, I mean, the East End has been annexed, what, 15 years ago? And it's like, the property line stops at Family Grocery. If you look at the East End of Gold Bar, it doesn't look nothing like Family Grocery West.
Well, we also, not only were we looking at Gun Road, we're looking at him brush up on Highway 2.
Yeah.
We're looking at him, clean that up. We're having him on First Ave West between First Street and Smelter Road.
Yeah.
We're having him look up at the far end of May Creek Road.
Yeah, I drove around town. It's been kind of bugging me a little bit, so I drove around town and those roads need it too, but not as bad as Gun Road, of course.
But we're looking at the total town.
Gun Road is first on my, getting it done, because it really needs it, because you're right, it's got to go one lane, it's got to be cleaned up.
So, I don't know, can you have a special meeting get?
It takes time to get a special meeting up and have it be published.
You know what I would suggest? I would wait until you get his estimates. You might call, he might be called prior to the next council meeting, knowing that he's going to submit a bid, and let him find out when he can be out there. I mean, it's not like he's going to give an estimate today and he's going to be there tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and I asked him, and he's pretty busy, but he knows that needs to be done. You know, we could push him for gun road or something, but, you know, you might get a call, say we need an estimate at least on gun road, and if we approve that, we need you as quick as could be. When is that? You know, I would go that way.
Thank you. That's a good way.
Thank you.
Any further citizen comments? Okay, we have no old business. We have in new business the ordinance 663, which was the subdivisions. The only thing that was on there was the changing from clerk treasurer to reading city staff. So you waited the 60 days for Department of Commerce, and now we can take action to approve it or disapprove it. So, can I get a motion for Ordinance 663 for final approval? Final action?
So moved.
I'll second that.
Does anyone wish to discuss this matter? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Motion is carried. We have gone out and got an estimate on a grant for a sidewalk funding, which will start in January of 2015. But the requirement on it is for the city to fund about 10% of it. This is going to be approximately $23,599. It's best if we go $27,500 just in case there's unforeseen contingencies. What this does is this brings it from the school down Fifth all the way to US 2. And the reason why they are allowing the grant is because we have all of our major city infrastructure, the fire department, the school, city hall. So they want to do the sidewalk all the way down. It's on one side. In that, they will also be putting in a storm drain for flooding and a crosswalk across Lewis. So it's safer for the kids to go from the school to US 2. So we need an action taken on whether or not to approve it for me to sign the contract to have this go forward. We have the REIT fund and the water fund. We do have the ability to pay it.
Which side of the street is it?
It's going to be on this side.
On this side?
Yes.
I have. There also is, there's going to be a new crosswalk as well. We haven't made a motion yet. We should make a motion.
Not for this.
No, we haven't made the motion yet.
But we should do that to discuss it.
Yes. Can I get a motion for...
I so move that we approve the sidewalk funding application and give the mayor authorization to sign page 2 to the amount of $27,500. Is that what you said?
Yes, if need be.
If need be, up to $27,500.
Can I get a
second? I'll second.
Does anyone wish to discuss this matter?
I'm just kind of a little curious. It says the crosswalks at Fifth and Lewis are deteriorating. I thought we just did those.
They're not really up to standards, and they're just getting...
The red ones?
Yeah, if you look at them. If you look at them, they're crazy.
You're crappy.
If I might add, not only signing page two, you have to authorize the mayor to sign the commitment letter to those funds also.
Well, I so moved to allow the mayor to sign the commitment letter to the funds. Yes.
So you're amending your initial motion? I need a second.
I'll be second.
I'll second, Ben.
Thank you. Are there any further comments?
The only one I have is, did you give a date for when this is gonna take place?
It begins January 2015. That's when construction will begin, once all of this is signed and they go forward.
And when on 2015?
And they have, start design engineering is January of 2015, the contract advertisement is June 2015, and the contract completion is September 2015.
And so the monies won't be spent until quite some time ago.
Right, you'll be approving it a second time through the budget process as well.
Yeah, good.
Right now, though, I need to do the commitment letter, and that's what you're approving at this point. Are there any further comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Motion carried. We have the annual Infrastructure Assistance Coordinating Council, IACC, conference coming up. And this is going to be a place where we can find out what grants are coming up for 2015. I would like myself and John to go to this conference. It's 3 days, so that is travel, the hotel, and the participation, registration to this.
Will John be back in time to go to that?
Yes, sir. This is from September 30th to October 2nd. And it's in Wenatchee.
Do we need a motion for this now?
Yes.
I make a motion that the council appropriate money for the mayor and the city director to attend this meeting, and also money to for their motel bills to save driving back and forth.
Can I get a second?
A second.
Do you have any comments on this? Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And it says here that scholarships are available. Can we look into getting?
I'll be looking into it first.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good. But
I know it's going to cost us something, but right, we can
but
get some assistance.
Where if the cities are even smaller than us, it's based on our financial stability.
Mm-hmm.
So I am looking into it actually, but mm-hmm. just in case it doesn't work, we have a backup.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Motion carried.
So those other classes you spoke of earlier, those are free to all members? The plan and all that?
Yeah, the overview.
All right.
Our one-time pickup, our water truck, the brakes went out on it, so it became a safety issue, and I had to make an immediate decision on it. So we went and got it repaired. In front of you is a detailed listing of what we had to do, which was both the front and the brakes. We had transmission leaking on the back calipers. Calipers had to be replaced. The water pump. And I think other major ones. The total amount cost $3,000 to get it repaired. I went down to
Leschwab.
Leschwab, and the difference was not enough to justify getting a tow truck to take it further down the road to Monroe. So we got that done. He has agreed, he let us have the truck back. I would like to get him paid prior to the next finance committee. This is why I put it on the council for today, so that it can get paid tomorrow. If I can get a motion to agree to get them paid at this short notice emergency that we had to get through.
I'll make the same motion that Mayor authorized to write the check for the truck repair.
Can I get a second?
Second.
Does anyone wish to discuss this matter? Yes, sir.
From reading some of the labor descriptions here, like the transmission is 2 quarts low on transmission, who's responsible for checking that before the
maintenance?
Correct.
No, no, what's the question
He's
again?
He's talking about the transmission fluid was 2 quarts low.
I mean, this seems like a laundry list of things that are wrong.
We are. Well, what's wrong with it? We're responsible for that. I'll make sure they check them tomorrow.
We'll get a written schedule going on, because that's one of the things that needs to be squared up. And I agree.
What year is that truck?
I don't know, but we haven't replaced one piece of anything since I've been here the last 15 and a half years.
It's a 96.
Yeah, it should be on here.
And it's got 79,000 miles on it. So.
So yeah, probably over 5,000 miles would be good schedule or something.
Right.
You use it a lot, right?
Yeah, all the time. Yeah. And you're opening doors, closing doors, 10 times a day, and start, stop.
Motor trucks are we have, who had us put it in the contract?
What's that?
Water pump.
Yeah, the water pump had replaced one of the bridges.
Yeah, we have, when the water comp plan is completed and we have it all approved, there is a truck replacement within the plan itself. It was recommended by.
It's time to do that.
DOT recommended.
You know, when we get budget time, we'll be talking about it.
Well, you can't deny that it's time to do something about that.
$3,000. We need to speak one at a time.
Actually, discussion should just be on the motion. You have a motion before you. So just on the bill. So that was appropriate, but kind of digressed. Sorry.
Okay.
Do we have a vote?
He was alone.
You can call for a vote.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? The motion is carried. Thank you. Are there any final council comments?
Now you can discuss the truck.
No. Yeah, thank you.
Now you have permission.
Well, I think the idea of some kind of preventive maintenance is an excellent strategy. You know, I know my tires, they email me when I need to have my tires rotated. Right. Yeah, it's getting really lazy out there. But it still is a good thing. Yeah,
that is.
Yeah.
I agree 100%.
Not only on the trucks, but I want to expand that. Like right now, we really need to get the vents cleaned out on the city hall. These kind of things are also necessary maintenance type items. So within the shop, within the building, and getting a preventive maintenance schedule together for everything that needs maintenance on a regular basis.
Good idea.
Great idea. And then the other thing that Lee and I were talking about earlier was that we were wondering what the status of the microphones for the council.
I haven't pursued it further. We just know that this one's down and it's down.
We're going to need a new PA system.
Exactly.
Oh.
Mainly because this one's obsolete, so therefore we can't get the repairs to it. So we have to go and get an actual new setup.
So taking into consideration the volume of people we get, because Lee's got a booming voice. If we all adjust to Lee a little bit, maybe we could get by without it.
Yeah, it's still for the public record. I mean, we had this guy. I guess that's enough. That's enough. We use a karaoke microphone or something. That's a microphone.
Megaphone. She brings the megaphone in.
It's just that we do on occasion have a full house. I know it's not often. And I really think it's respectful to be able for the entire audience to hear us. I don't like spending money. I hate spending money.
Did
even
other we want to for the
I think it's respectful.
One at a time, please.
I'll quit. I'm done. Thank you.
I don't think it would hurt to check into that to find out what a system would cost. I wouldn't have any idea who to check with, but if you tell me, I'll do it. I suppose Markley would know who to talk to.
Any sound system type company, so we'll look into it and also look into perhaps we can get a grant in that aspect as well. Don't know yet, but first I'll go to the PA system people, audio system people, and see what it would take to get in something that's not going to go obsolete in a couple of years.
Okay.
Is that possible? Today's
no.
Electronics.
Are you going to do that then?
Yes. Because you still have the crosswalk, and I'd like to continue on that because you're doing really good with that. And he has the activity center. I can take this one on. Davey keeps up on the fire department and chamber of commerce meetings and other meetings, I believe, that you go to.
Well, and on the crosswalk thing, I did get a letter back from John Holt, the assistant director for safety in the Department of Transportation. And he told me that, of course, there'll be no more funds this year after July 16th. But he said if we would give them a detailed information on exactly what we want, that he would help us look for ways to get it funded. So John, I talked to John about that today, and he is going to look into that from some of the engineers that he knows, and we'll get back on that after John gets back from his trips and is getting his shoulder fixed.
And we'll do it before that. I'll get a hold of Blue Line.
Okay. One final comment I'd like to make is the community garden, the tomatoes are getting ripe. Anybody and everybody can go pick whatever they want out of there. Please, go do it. It's for the city. We have the August 4th minutes approval.
Go ahead.
Can I get a motion for approving the minutes of August 4th?
I will move to approve the minutes for Monday, August 3rd. It was National Night Out, was August 4th.
Monday, August 4th.
August 3rd.
Monday was
August 4th. What you're changing is
The fifth was night out.
The fifth was night out, okay, great. Monday, the fourth, right.
Okay, to amend the minutes to read Monday rather than Tuesday. Can I get approval with that?
I'll second the amendment.
And all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Questions carried? Amended minutes. Can I get voucher approval?
Hi, I move that we approve checks number 30060 through 30086 for a total of $22,568.32, of which $15,695.82 are for claims and $6,872.50 are for payroll.
Can I get a second?
I'll second the motion.
The one comment that I have to make from the finance committee point of view is that really we're real close to where we're at on budget for the year. We do not have any spare room that I noticed. So I'm just going to bring that to everybody's attention. So I was glad the sidewalk one is coming out of next year's budget, not this year's. But I didn't see where it was going to happen.
As it stands, budget was estimated pretty close to what we're using.
Oh yeah, we're doing as I've never ever had any issue with the city staff in following budgets, ever. All of the issues have come from outside sources. So, or outside that most of the city people can do anything about. So, I'm very happy with that.
Thank you. Bring these come up. That's going to be taken care of. Can I, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion's carried. Do we have any citizen comments? Can I get a motion for adjournment of the meeting?
I said move to adjourn the meeting.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The meeting is adjourned.
I'm really sorry Jay didn't show up.
Me too.
Yeah, damn it, I was looking forward to that.
We're going to have a real...
Yeah, Jay. Joe was here, whatever.